Are you encouraged by the Browns after that win?
Hell no. I wasn't encouraged. I'm not impressed. I'm just looking at this schedule right here. I mean, if you look, if you go down the list and you just look at the Rams, and I'm sorry, the Browns and what's coming forward, there is a Thursday night encounter against against the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Yeah, he's good.
You know, you got to. One would say it was a bye week against Miami, but they have won two straight, so we have to give their respect where it's due. Another game against the Steelers. You think they're going to win both of those games against the Steelers? I don't think they're going to win both of those games against the Steelers, okay? So that's at least one loss, okay? So that would be seven on the season. They got the hapless Cincinnati Bengals twice. Very, very lucky on their part. But in between that, they got Arizona with Kyler Murray. And, of course, they have the Baltimore Ravens, who they stomped earlier this season. You really, really think that's going to happen again? I don't think so. So I'm thinking it's at least a minimum or two losses that's coming their way. They already got six. That makes them 8-8. So what war are you ready for? Whatever war are you ready for? One would argue, Jarvis Landry, you already lost. And so when I look at the Cleveland Browns,
he got a touchdown.
Listen, Jarvis Landry could play. He's a good dude, too, but he could ball.
Yes,
okay,
he can.
And we understand that. I ain't like the penalty, the taunt the penalty that he got, because you don't need to be taunting anybody at this particular juncture. Mm-hmm. But in the end, he's a baller. He's a good dude and what have you. Odell Beckham Jr. Targeted the first four times, didn't catch any of them early on. That was a struggle. Nick Chubb is a monster. Mm. And brother special, Kareem Hunt. Oh, by the way, if you are Freddie Kitchens, right, they lucky that it got overturned because it was a forward pass. Yeah. What the hell are you doing? Trying to call some misdirection play and you tossing the football. It's clearly a timing play for a dude that's been going the first 8 weeks. Yeah. These are the kind of things that we see from the Cleveland Browns. Max Kellerman, I'll close by saying this. Mm-hmm. Hell no. Okay? To whatever question anybody got about, oh, my goodness.
Are you encouraged?
Please.
The question is, are you encouraged?
I'm not.
And I am.
I'm
now,
not.
I think the playoff ship has sailed.
Okay.
And I think the Broncos game was the game. When I looked at this season, when I looked at the schedule, I looked and thought they could be 2-5 when that schedule starts to soften. That's like a worst case scenario. And then if they catch fire, maybe they can make the playoffs. The worst case scenario came to be. And then they lost to the Broncos, and I thought, all right, they really needed that win. Like they put themselves in a dug themselves a hole. They really needed that win. But I'm talking about, can you be encouraged going forward? First of all, let's start with the head coach. Kitchens does not have the executive capacity, it looks like, to be a head coach in the NFL, or didn't at least when he just first started out. After a year of experience, let's see what he comes up with. Now, what did he have available to him, and why were we all excited about the Browns? The name brands all over the field for them were not just in name. They were in their primes, offense and defense. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We knew the line was going to take time to come together, but when we looked at starting like from least of, Njoku was like the least of your worries, and he's really good, hasn't been available. Kareem Hunt and Nick Chubb, two backs like that, but you weren't going to have Kareem Hunt right away. Yeah. Tyreek Hill and Travis Kelce, but Tyreek Hill was hurt. Excuse me, I say Tyreek Hill and Travis Kelce. Odell Beckham Jr. and Jarvis Landry, but Odell hasn't been targeted. And they weren't making use of the fact that he was double-teamed, so Landry should be open. Now, all of a sudden, you look at what happened. Kareem Hunt comes back. He's blocking for Nick Chubb, springing runs. Mm-hmm. You have them both on the field at the same time. Because of that, there's more for the defense to focus on. So now the double team for Odell means Jarvis is open and Baker Mayfield's finding him. Not that Baker was any great shakes, but Baker threw the winning pass.
Yeah.
And the running backs did their thing. And Njoku, it turns out, is going to be back in a couple of weeks. Things are looking up for this team.
Well, here's why I'm encouraged, because I feel like they did have a psychological breakthrough that you need when you're going through multiple losses, when you have the misfortune of not having a good start that you need under a new head coach who didn't come into the position with experience. Because I can tell you from sources, they always say behind the scenes, if left tackle Greg Robinson didn't get thrown out in that first game, they feel like they would have been on a magic carpet ride and it wouldn't have had a negative domino effect. And they always say, oh, the media doesn't understand Baker Mayfield, because when they go back and they look at the tape, most of those mistakes are not on Baker Mayfield. So they needed this, you know, to just spring them. I saw Charles Woodson, Ed Reed, dap up those boys after the game. I heard hip-hop music coming from the locker room, all that kind of good vibes or whatever. So I feel like when I have a guy like Jarvis Landry come up to me in the middle of the game, or excuse me, before the game, and say, hey, Joe, we got to have this. And if we focus for four quarters, we can do it. Or if Kareem Hunt, you know, basically brings all that emotion from not playing from 356 days and delivers and shows you what you can do creatively on offense, those things can parlay itself. Because I know you mentioned all those teams that they have, but still, they got to face Cincinnati twice. Those are potentially two wins. Arizona, I know you're looking at me like, oh, whatever. But I'm just saying.
They got to go three.
You brought up Cincinnati. That's why you got that look.
Yes, but they have to have an initial step, and they had that yesterday.
They got to go.